This video is about Excel checkboxes. It's a feature which was introduced recently. Technically speaking, it's not a new feature, but the way it is implemented is new and more convenient. So what is a checkbox? It's just a tick mark. Now, from a technical point of view, how do you add it? Insert checkbox. Insert menu doesn't have a checkbox button. What does that mean? Two things. Either you don't have the right version of Excel, you need the Office 365 version of Excel. Now, sometimes you have the Office 365 version of Excel, but you still don't have it. That means your copy is not updated. This is a recent feature. It is still rolling out. So it may take a little while for it to reach you. So let's start simple. I select something, insert checkbox, hit put checkboxes. No brainer. Now, when I click on each one of them, it's either yes or no. Behind the scenes, what's happening? The checkbox is only a visual indication. Excel doesn't understand a checkbox. Excel understands true and false. So true and false is called logical. From an interaction point of view, instead of typing true or false or 1 or 0, you can just interact with it. Click on it with mouse or on a touch screen, just touch it. So from a functional interaction point of view, it has become simpler. So before we explore the new checkbox, let's understand how to use checkbox in any version of Excel. Look at the menus. Do you see a menu called Developer? It's technically called a tab. Don't see it? No problem. Right click on the ribbon and say customize the ribbon. On the right side, you will see all the menus. One of them is not selected. That's called the Developer tab. Enable it, click OK. Now you will see the Developer tab. When you go to the Developer tab, open it, click on Insert. You will see two sections. One is called Form Controls, one is called ActiveX Controls. So under Form Controls, you will see Checkbox. You will see many other things also, but we are going to focus on Checkbox. Now, when you click on the Checkbox, it allows you to draw a box which has a checkbox inside. The difference is this checkbox is just hanging in the air. It's not a part of any cell. It's not controlling any actual Excel cell. Now, to do that, you have to right-click on it, go to Format Controls, click on the cell link, and then specify the cell. So now this checkbox controls this cell. We click on it, it becomes true. Unclick, becomes false. So now we have achieved parity with the new feature. So what did the new feature do? All this jugglery, it eliminated. Insert checkbox, true, false. So now let's figure out how to use the new checkbox in more detail. You can have multiple selections and insert checkbox as well. If I remove formatting by going to clear format, the checkbox goes, but the true false is still there. So the new checkbox is like formatting, not data. If you go to the format dialog, you will still not see add a checkbox option. Probably that is coming, we don't know. Right now, checkbox is the first incarnation of modern controls. Microsoft has promised that more controls are coming. More means what? We just saw under form controls, there was not just checkbox. There was a radio button. There was scroll bar, combo box, text box, all of them hopefully will come soon. If I already have data and then I try to insert checkbox, what happens? If that data is of true false kind, then it will map the checkbox. If the data is not true false, if I put 1 and 0, it will not disturb it. So existing data is not affected by inserting checkbox unless it's logical. Now, if there is already a checkbox and you copy, even copy formatting will work because as I told you, it's formatting. If you want to remove formatting, what do you do? Clear formats? Yes. But there is a shortcut. Many people don't know about the shortcut. It's a long shortcut. Alt-E-A-F. So now we have seen how to use checkboxes. Let's talk about the more important topic, when to use them. Most of the videos and blogs talk about task list. Technically, as a demo, that's good. But practically, you should not use Excel for tasks. You should use other apps for tasks. In fact, I have a very comprehensive video on which task management tool you should use. Have a look at that. So the practical use of it is checklists. Now, checklist means this is a process. This is a checklist for recruitment. If I want to recruit a person, I have to follow these steps. Now, I am recruiting multiple people. So I need multiple checklists? No. I manage the checklist, I reset it and come back. So how do I reset a checklist? That's important. I put a checklist, some of them are true, some of them are false. Now, select all and press space bar. Spacebar does what? It looks at the active cell. Is it true or false? Depending on that, the spacebar will affect the entire selection. Usually, when there is anything selected in Excel, you do something to the active cell, it affects only the active cell. Here, it affects all cells, and how it affects depends on the contents of the active cell. In fact, underlying principle is true and false. So, if I have a list of checkboxes and I put them in an AND condition, I just say AND entire checklist. What is it going to look at? AND means true. So, if I have true, false, true, false, true, false, are all of them true? No. So, unless all of them are true, AND is going to give me false. Now, there is another function called OR. OR means what? Either one of them is true, it'll give me true. So, a very intelligent way to understand the overall picture of a list of checkboxes is a use of AND and OR. Now, coming to the checklist itself, you want to know the total items in the checklist and you want to know the completed items. That's two functions. COUNT will only count the enabled or true ones, and COUNT A will count the whole list. Simple. Now, let's look at a more practical use of checkboxes. Comparisons. So, here is a list. I'm comparing Excel and Power BI. Every row talks about a feature and I'm saying this feature exists in Excel, this doesn't exist in Power BI. That's a comparison kind of scenario. Comparators are very good use case for checkboxes. What is the benefit? I just tick mark. Easy. I don't have to type yes, no manually. And when you type yes, no, the uppercase, lowercase goes for a toss. 1-0, confusion, checkbox makes it clean. Error-free data entry. But there is one more refined use of comparators. When you are comparing two or more things, some things will match, some things will not match. And as a person who is evaluating those products, in this case Excel and Power BI, I am more interested in the differences. So how do I find the differences? So I put one more column there called difference. And in that column, I am doing a simple. Is this matching this? If it is not, then I also put a checkbox there to show. If that checkbox is empty, that means they are not matching. That means it's a different thing. And then if you filter on that, then you can easily only filter on differences, making your comparison easy. Now, this is a built-in solution inside a table. If you want a separate table, only showing differences, that's also possible. So, I don't want to show the base table. I want to show a copy of the table. And there, I want to give another checkbox which says only show differences. If I remove the checkbox, everything is shown. If I say only differences, only that is done. How do we do that? Well, there the magic of filter function comes into picture. Remember, filter function only available in Office 365 versions, will not work on desktop versions. So, filter function, first parameter is what to filter. I have given the entire table. And then, second parameter of filter is say filter based on what? In the filter itself, I have to decide whether to filter or not depending on the show differences checkbox. So, that's what I'm doing here. That's why I need an if condition. So, what is that if condition doing? It is looking at show only difference. If I am showing only difference, then it is going to the table and saying, is Excel matching with Power BI? If it is not matching, show it. Easy. So, it's only filtering those which are different. If I don't want to show differences, I want to show the whole table. That's the other part of if. There, I want to show the entire set of rows. Now, for filter to understand that, I need an array which contains the same number of rows and all of them should be true. How do you do that? Well, that's where the sequence function comes into picture. So, the sequence function is creating an array. How many things should be there in the array? Same number as rows in the table. So, that's how this filter function works. Now, another scenario. How do I create proposal calculators? So, this falls under the category of configurators or business modeling. So, business modeling means what? I put my business context in Excel terms. So, first of all, I have this table. This table talks about these are the type of people I have and this is their per day rate. That's a static information. Now, I'm creating a proposal for a customer. So, I've given the same people and I'm saying how many days of each person is required. So, I put the numbers here. And then simple calculation gives me cost. Nothing special there. But then there are some variables. The variables are, do I want to give them discount? If yes, how much discount? Second, do I want to include support in it? Yes, no. Then, I also want to have a buffer because people keep adding extra functionality and then I exceed my cost and profit goes down. So we always keep a buffer. So do I want to add a buffer or not? So all these three questions, discount, support, buffer are yes, no questions. So remember, yes, no question, it should strike you. Use checkbox. So I have put discount percentage, support cost and buffer percentage. There is no checkbox there. But in the configurator, I put, do you want to give discount? Checkbox. Do you want to include support? Checkbox. Do you want to put buffer? Checkbox. And based on that, the further calculations are happening. So now let's see how these checkboxes are put in action. So if I enable the discount checkbox, it deducts the discount percent. How does it do that? If it is true, finds out the percentage value, deducts it. Simple. Next one is support. If support is included, I just add the support cost. It's not a percentage, fixed cost. And the last one is buffer, same as discount, but here I am adding the percentage instead of subtracting it. And finally, I get the total. Now, look at how easy it has become for me to configure my proposal creation process. Now, you can use this for any kind of business modeling, and checkbox is just one component, by the way. If you use all the other form components like scroll bars, this becomes even more sophisticated. Just as a quick example, here I have hard-coded the percentage as 10% for discount. Let's say I want to play with it and see how my total cost changes. I put a scroll bar and I get a very interactive way of configuring the proposal. How was this done? Oh, that is a topic for another video. So bottom line, checkbox is just simple true and false, but using it correctly will refine the way you work. So I hope I have given you enough material to get you started with checkboxes and explore the form controls as well. Did I miss a use case? Do you want me to create a video on a particular use case? Do let me know in comments. In fact, when you share, subscribe, comment, all that lets YouTube know that this video is useful, so it is going to show it to more people. So you and me together can make the world a more efficient place. So that's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.